The principal judge, Flavian Zajan, noted that laziness in the public service is a tall order intensified by absence of immediate sanctions to non-performance.
When I sit and look at the way we do things in the private sector, and I reflect what I used to do in the private sector, I just realized that many of you wouldn't even survive for a day in the private sector. Now, I can give you very interesting examples. You see, in the private sector, you have targets. You have deliverables. Those targets are measured periodically. If, for example, you are a loans officer, they will say, we expect you to bring 100 clients in a month. Now, so you will be measured according to how many clients you have brought. If by the end of the month you have brought 3 instead of 100, they will put you on a performance improvement plan. When by the second month you have managed to bring in 20, then they call you to show cause why you should not leave the organization.
He made the remarks while officiating at the launch of a book written by the permanent secretary in the judiciary, Pius Bigirimana, titled A Small Book of Big Courts, extracted from the 6 books written by the same author. Zajan noted that most public servants don't stick to their offices for long because they later on in the day disappear.
On the chair, and he goes the whole day. The person is not there. Comes in the evening, picks his coat, and goes. And life continues.
He hailed Bigirimana for importing the private sector's mentality into the judiciary, which has improved staff performance. Zajan urged Ugandans to support local authors by quoting their literature if this sector is to develop.
Promoting literacy, celebrating our local writers can also have a profound impact on literacy rates and the love of reading within our communities. When we quote their words, we inspire others to explore their works, fostering a culture of reading and intellectual curiosity. Because you see, when you quote foreigners, there is no reason that should make me look for their works. I don't need to. But when you quote a local person, I will be curious to know what has he written about.
Bigirimana explained why he authored an intimate book which he named Naked Truth, a book which details stories of African sex magic treasures.
I not write this book as an academician, neither did I write it as a scholar. I wrote it as a parent with children, but also I wrote it as a person who cares about what happens in this institution called marriage. For those who are married and those who aspire to get married, to understand this subject so that they respect it.
Bigirimana also received praises for writing about the new spate of syndicated corruption, and the principal judge called for new measures tackling the vice which has penetrated the juveniles.
We revere the corrupt. Actually, when you are corrupt, you come. Even our churches, they never ask you where you got the money from. You come and they give you the front seat. They never mind where you get the money from. It's about corruption. That's a serious conversation we must have as a society.
I want to encourage you people, to put something down. Because you never know what you put down might be of value to some people.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.